So you can use the dictation commands feature of your Mac to actually speak keyboard shortcuts rather than type them. So to enable this, you want to go into System Preferences and under Accessibility, look for Dictation on the left. Now in order to enable dictation commands without having to actually use the keyboard to activate these commands, you can click this box here. And now it's going to use this term here to actually activate the listening for commands. So you could say the word here and whatever the command is. Now if you click on dictation commands, you see all the commands you can use. There's a bunch already there. There's more if you click enable advanced commands. So you can do a lot that has to do with typing text. You can do a bunch of stuff with editing. So shortcuts for things like copy and paste, there are already shortcuts for that, like copy that and paste that. There's even things for formatting, and even you can even start dictation, stop dictation using commands as well. So you've got lots of things here. Save document, open document. These are all things that you might use keyboard shortcuts for, and there are already ways to do it with dictation commands. But you can add any keyboard shortcut. So as a simple example, let's just make text bold. So I'm going to hit plus, and this, instead of making the selected text bold like the default command in there, it will actually use the command B keyboard shortcut. So everything you type after that is bold, and then you could toggle it off with the same command. So I'll just use the word bold. Any application, though, it's always best to restrict it to a specific app if you can. And then I can choose from lots of things here, including the ability to paste text, meaning I could say have a paragraph that maybe something I respond to people in email with a lot. I could actually put that in there and then use a dictation command to paste that in there instead of the text replacement function that has me using the keyboard. But let's do press keyboard shortcut here. And I'll just say command B. That's a shortcut I want to use. So now with that done, all I should need to do is speak this command and say the word. Now it's important that you give a pause, because if you're dictating or talking like I am here, it's not going to differentiate that command there. So if I just say the word computer in this sentence, it's not going to take that as an initiation of dictation commands. But if I pause and say it, it will. Computer, bold. Computer, bold. Computer, bold. You can even use it with dictation, though it can be a bit frustrating sometimes to get the command to be recognized. You have to pause enough so it just doesn't think it's part of the text. So let's try to do this without even touching the keyboard. Computer, start dictation. This is a test, period. Bold. This is a test of bold text, period. Bold. And now it is off, period. Stop dictation. So there you go. I was able to do that entire thing without touching the keyboard. Now, I was just using a simple bolding of text, but you could use just about anything. So I could have done, you know, command S for save, even though I already have that command there. But if there are other things that you need to do, you can add them in and then use them while you're dictating, or use them while typing. But you don't have to remember what the keyboard shortcut is. You can just say it. There are a lot of good commands already in here that you can use. And in addition to that, you can also choose, instead of a keyboard shortcut, to select a menu. And you can enter the menu item title. So if there's no keyboard shortcut assigned to it, you don't have to add a keyboard shortcut and then use this. You can just go right to the menu item. Now in practice, this didn't seem to work with a lot of menu items, but one that did was centering. So let's try that as an example. When I say center in any application, it's going to select the menu center. Done. So I can now go here, and if I say computer center, you can see it works. So I was able to get that to work. I wasn't able to get ones like Outline or Underline or anything like that to work. So your mileage may vary for those. Also note that there are a lot of other ways to get to menu commands. For instance, there is already a built-in way to just choose a menu. You could say click menu and that is listed under application. Click and then the menu name menu. And then you use numbers. So for instance, if I wanted to underline this without hitting the keyboard shortcut, I could say computer, click format menu. Computer 1. Computer 4. So you could see what it did there was it used those numbers that were listed and I was able to simply use those numbers to get to what I wanted. Now you should be able to actually say just the number and not have to say computer 1, computer 4. But that's also something that didn't seem to work all the time for me. But it did seem to work all the time if I prefaced it with computer. So there's some things for you to play around with if you want an alternative to using keyboard shortcuts and actually have spoken shortcuts. ¶¶